I have with me Dr. Ashutosh Sharma. He is spearheading India's cyber physical protection system, a very important announcement by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Of late, we have seen two important cyber security issues, one on WhatsApp and one on the Kodankulam nuclear plant. Dr. Ashutosh, what is this cyber physical project and how will it help India?
I'm very glad you're asking that question, Pallava, because cyber physical systems is all of future. So it has a beginning, it has begun, but it has no end. So whether you talk about Industry 4.0, whether you think about thinking machines, whether you talk about robotics or Internet of Things or Internet of Everything, so you talk about artificial intelligence or machine learning, all of these are part of cyber physical systems. Now, what is a cyber physical system? It is basically convergence of many technologies together to make a bundle which looks like a person. So what is it, bundle? So it has communication in it. We know that we are getting into 5G and very soon 6G and beyond. So fast, reliable communication which connects this machine to the rest of the world in a seamless way. At the same time, it's got perception, what we call sensors. So it's bringing in relevant data from environment around it. Is pulling in data, information from wherever it exists. At the same time, it's got decision making, which is artificial intelligence. So based on this multi-dimensional big data, you come up with some conclusions about what you need to do, how you need to do it. And at the same time, it's got action or autonomous action, which is called actuator. So you see, the future is about the convergence of technology, communication, computing, decision making, perception, action.
So what lesson have you learned from this so-called cyber attack which happened on the Kodankulam nuclear plant?
Cyber attack and cyber security is one aspect of cyber physical systems. So whenever you have a physical machine which is connected to the outside world, it is vulnerable to whatever happens in the outside world. So it is a special case of cyber security of machines, of infrastructure. Certainly there is a hub which is being developed related to cyber security in Internet of Things. Everything is Internet of Things, whatever is connected, whether it's reactor, whether it is railways, whether it is powerhouses, whether it is grid. So all of this, in fact, we established already a center related to cyber security of physical infrastructure at IIT Kanpur. Is functioning fantastically. In fact, they isolated 6 threats or malware which had escaped detection even of the international standard operating systems, and they were recognized for that, and they are doing extremely great work, and this is going to be helpful for security of all our infrastructure.
So should we feel safe after this WhatsApp hack, what is called, and this Kodankulam nuclear plant threat, that people like you are working hard to make sure that India's infrastructure remains secure?
Yes, and we have to be ever vigilant about it, because it's not a one-time thing. It is an ongoing battle all the time, and
it's an asymmetric war.
Prepare on every hourly basis. So while you prepare, while you do things, things happen all over the world. And so this is not business as usual, this is disruptive. And so what it means is that we have to be fully prepared every second of the way. And we are working in that direction.
So that was Professor Ashutosh Sharma telling us that one has to be ever vigilant in this world of cyber security, and the cyber physical systems project, which his department has initiated in a very big way, will help secure India's infrastructure. At the India International Science Festival in Kolkata, Pallava Bagla.